Zoonotic diseases. Okay, first off, let's talk about what a zoonotic disease is. By definition, the word means diseases that transfer to humans from animals, and most of which have no cure. That is because many of these diseases are strains that the human body has never seen before. Therefore, we have no antibodies ready to fight them, which I think makes zoonotic diseases even more scary. They can range from tapeworms to the plague, or more appropriately, coronavirus. The vast majority of these diseases come from livestock, like cattle, pigs, chickens, goats, etc. In other countries, specifically Asian countries, the cuisine can get a little more exotic. You can easily find dog or cat on the menu, but don't worry, it's not just the cute fluffy animals they like to eat. They also eat snakes, rats, bats, sharks. Honestly, it seems like anything with a pulse, you can find being killed and eaten somewhere in the world. And you don't have to dig very hard before you see a pattern of zoonotic diseases following in the wake of the consumption of these animals. Around the world, zoonotic diseases kill a crazy amount of people. By comparison, heart disease, the number one killer in America, kills about 650,000 people every year. But that number is nothing when compared to the 2.2 million people killed every year from zoonotic diseases. So coronavirus is our current pandemic, and it's been confirmed that it came from the consumption of and or experiments on bats in China. But honestly, compared to past zoonotic diseases, COVID is child's play. The Black Death back in the 14th century tragically wiped out 50 million humans. It's considered to be the worst in history. The Black Death originated from small mammals and the fleas that infest them. Mad cow disease, which originated by feeding cows remains from other dead cows. For one, cows are herbivores and are not designed to eat meat. Secondly, how messed up and disgusting is that? The most popular, and the one that may just kill us all, is the avian flu. The strain of influenza has made its rounds several times. In 1994, in 2004, 2006, and 2013. And experts say that there's a strain of avian flu that is likely to become the great pandemic of the 21st century. Although this has not happened yet, it's only a matter of time until the virus mutates to become capable of mass human infection, and possibly extinction. Antibiotic resistance is occurring on a very large scale now because of the antibiotics being pumped into all the livestock we eat. Our bodies process those antibiotics, and over time we become completely immune to the effects of antibiotics altogether. Meaning that we're brewing up the perfect storm for a mass human extinction. We're creating these entire country-killing zoonotic diseases by improper care and handling of the animals. And we're weakening our immune system, making ourselves more susceptible to dying from basically anything. And we're doing that through the animal agriculture industry as well. I wonder when people are going to wake up. What will it take? It'll take your mother dying from it, maybe your husband or wife dying from it. Maybe it'll take you getting deathly ill and making a miraculous recovery. Whatever it takes, it kind of feels like we're already too late to save ourselves. As a species, humans are failing our planet. We're failing ourselves. Our detachment from what we eat has killed millions of humans and trillions of animals. And we act like we don't care because it doesn't affect us. Wake up, people. Does death have to be knocking at your door for you to finally understand the consequences of your actions? Frankly, it's more important now than ever to encourage everyone you know to stop eating animals. This is really the only way to prevent millions and millions of people from dying. Every time we go to the store and buy the flesh of a dead animal to consume, we're supporting the very machine that is killing us. The reason we have to wear a mask everywhere and can't go to the movies is because of our needless obsession with killing and eating animals. It will never stop until we stop supporting the meat and dairy industry. That's just the facts of it. I was looking for a lighthearted spin to put on this, but frankly, there wasn't one. My biggest fear is that in the future, we'll look back at this video and say, damn, we should have listened. We're not the chosen species. We're not special and removed from nature. We are nature. And nature can be a real bitch if you don't respect her. Sorry if this video was a bit of a downer, but when I was researching zoonotic diseases to write this script, I was incredibly demoralized. The sad thing is there are a lot of people who have gotten COVID and gotten really sick and recovered from it and still continue to eat meat. And it really just blows my mind. make sure you subscribe and ring that bell for more videos. The next video is going to be what I eat in a day to gain some weight. Stay tuned for that. We'll see you later, guys.